Jesus, as one body, unified in this, under Christ. Calling our angel of the house, apostle, not being out of order, but getting in order. Even though when the enemy wants to tell us to get out of order, thinking that we know we got to get in order, and like we don't know, because we don't know Jesus. Whew. We don't know. Glory to God. We just bless your name. Lord, we thank you for all that you've done and all that you're about to do in this place. And then for those who are watching right now, I don't know who needs this word, but this word is a good word. If you missed us on Friday, the part one was on Friday live on Apostle John T. Wiggins' page. Look for part one there. There's part two that's coming today. Today, from the word, will be coming from Psalms 104, verses 1 through 7. Psalms 104. Verses 1 through 7. Come on. Yes. Give God some praise, y'all.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Let's give it again. Let's give it again. Hallelujah. We bless your name, God.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
We bless your name. So let's get our minds focused on him and this word that's about to come forth. Let's not think about ourselves, not about other people. Let's think about this word. Because we want to have this word that's going to help deliver more people and give it, reach it, reach it. Millions and across the oceans, reach the people, God.
Yes, God.
So pay attention to this word.
Yes, Lord.
Today.
Jesus.
Psalms 104, yes. Verses 1 through 7. Psalms 104, verses 1 through 7. Get your Bibles ready.
Yes, God. Thank you, Lord.
Yes. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Bless his name. Bless his name. Fear his name. Fear him. My God. Fear him. All right, everyone stand on their feet. We're going to welcome our apostle of the house, our chief apostle. Praise be to God. Our chief apostle, Apostle John T.
It was deliverance on a mass scale, and it will be deliverance for you today. Don't you know that darkness is following you? Don't you know that's why you're going through? Don't you know that's why you need to be new? I'm going to show you. See, we go through life, and we've been going through this thing, not being aware that there's a level of darkness that's following you. I know you think that it's COVID, but COVID is a response of God to get you to the light, not take you deeper into the darkness. Unfortunately, since you've been walking with darkness for so long, you can't recognize that light is what you need. Interesting that vitamin D is found in sunlight. It's interesting enough that that's what they say helps with the COVID. Something with some light will take care of something that makes your lungs dark. The SARS version of it makes your lungs dark. Like you've been smoking cigarettes for 100 years. Dark. But you need some light. It's interesting that when you get cancer, they take you for some radiation. You need some light. It's interesting that they're using laser surgery on the laser surgery on every form of surgery because you need some light. It seems like everything with light is making do what needs to be done. And everything with dark is making you done. See, when you put it in the oven, your chicken starts to get dark. When you put it on the barbecue grill, it starts to get dark. My God, have you been on the barbecue or in the oven? outside. But when the darkness gets on the inside, and the light has come on the outside, baby, you are burnt.
Jesus. Yes. Hallelujah.
Whether you put it in the microwave, you are burnt. Whether you go on the barbecue pit, you are burnt. Whether you go into the frying pan, you are burnt. Whether you go into the bonfire, you are burnt. See, darkness is supposed to stay on the outside to make you delicious on the inside. I'm talking to somebody today. See, darkness is supposed to stay on the outside to make you delicious on the inside. I'm talking to somebody today. The s'more ain't right unless it's burnt on the outside. Get it nice and gooey and soft on the inside. See, but you gotta keep the darkness on the outside. Because if it gets in the inside, baby, it's burnt.
Thank you, God.
You get a suntan on the outside. So you're so light and feel good on the inside. But then if you get too much heat on the outside, you get burnt on the inside, you got a stroke, baby, you got a stroke. Tighten up on your backstroke, hallelujah. So see, what happens is, but you gotta have, darkness is supposed to stay on the outside. So even when Jesus went up on the cross, darkness was trying to get on the inside, but he had to give up the ghost to get the light on the inside and keep the darkness on the outside. Sometimes the only way you can get past some things is if you cope with the darkness until you turn on the light. Come into the light, she said. It's time for you to come into the light. It's time for you to stop hiding in the darkness of the inside of your house. It's time for you to stop hiding in the darkness of the inside of your house, what you call your body. You in the darkness of the inside of your house. Some of y'all are sitting around and you talk about people sitting in the bedroom and COVID, but you sitting in the bedroom of COVID inside of yourself. The same way they sitting there locked in a room, you locked in a room inside yourself. In the darkness, in the dark room, in yourself. You're living in the closet, in the inside of yourself. It's one thing to live into the closet of outside, but to live into a closet inside yourself. To live inside a dark jail cell inside yourself. My God, to live inside a dark jail cell inside yourself. My God, to be locking yourself up inside a safe in yourself. You're trying to keep your emotions safe, so you put them in a vault inside yourself. But it's dark in a vault, and there is no air in a vault, and you will suffocate. Maybe that's why you feel like you suffocate most of the time. Even if you don't have COVID, you feel like you're suffocating. You can't even smile because you feel like you're suffocating. You can't move because you feel like you're suffocating. You can't do anything new because you feel like you're suffocating. But I'm here to tell you today that you need to get out the vault. Unlock the vault. Get from out the wall. Jump and break out the closet. My God, come into the light. Come on outside. Let the darkness back outside. Then come back inside and bring the light back inside. Bring the light back inside yourself. Bring the light back inside your dream. Bring the light back inside your vision. Bring the light back inside your life. Make sure you leave the darkness on the outside. I've got an Oreo cookie, got the light on the inside and the dark on the outside. That makes a whole cookie, baby. Let that darkness stay on the outside and keep your vanilla cream on the inside. I'm talking to somebody today. They don't want this work, don't want this work, or we don't want this work. Let me tell you something. See, the problem is that you're so busy staying in the darkness that you don't even know what it's like to be in the light. See, it's time for you to see, you got so many dark thoughts, so many dark things going on in your brain that the world is even feeding you more darkness. There's darkness on the video. There's darkness on the Facebook. There's darkness in the YouTube. My God, there's darkness in the Instagram. There's darkness in the Twitter. My God, there's darkness, there's darkness, there's darkness. There's darkness in the Snap and the Chat. You in there just so disgraceful and so distasteful. You can't even be you in person because you got a whole other personality in the darkness that's hidden. You one personality on Facebook, one personality on Instagram, one first personality on Snapchat, one personality on Twitter. And no personality in person. You can talk all tough on the Facebook. You can get gangster on Snapchat. My God, my God, my God. You can go all out war on the Instagram. But in person, you nobody even sees you. Because you're hidden in the darkness. Hidden in the darkness. See, this is what's going wrong with you. You want to shine, but how can you shine when you got so much darkness cloaking your face? You want to shine on Facebook, but you're blending in because all the shining people dare to be different and dare to be good. And all the dark people tend to be bad. In other words, you're always talking about somebody. You go on Facebook, you always call yourself putting somebody on blast. You never thought of you, nobody cares. There's so much blast on Facebook, you might as well be in the moon. Take off. Let's go. There's so much negativity on YouTube, it's the boob tube. Where's the positive things that you have to say that will gather some attention? COVID was a thing that was used for darkness, but it was really something God got to bring forth the light. But the darkness came because everybody wants to talk about the horrors of COVID, but it talked about it so much so that everybody right now is having big house parties right now. COVID is still going on the same way it was going on when it started. Even when you get the shot, but nobody's talking about it now. It's all good now. Just put your mask up, get a sandwich, and let's go. It used to be a time you got in trouble for wearing a mask. They thought you was about to rob something. Now everybody look like they robbing something. Could it be maybe we are robbing something? The mask got you looking like a dark ninja. You're going in the supermarket looking like ninjas. You're going, my God, you're in your business looking like ninjas. You're going over people's house looking like ninjas. You're going to the Walmart looking like a ninja. My God, you must be a security nightmare right now. Because everybody's looking like ninjas. The little kids are looking like ninjas. Even the dog is looking like a ninja. I went to the Walmart, the service dog had a mask on. A whole family of ninjas. Dog, mom, dad, kids, and others. Ninjas. But even before the mask came out, you were still a ninja. You was on Facebook acting like you was somebody else. My current situation, that wasn't your car. My current situation, you was at Cocoa Keys, Mount Laura, not Florida. Got your bathing suit on, making it look like you down at the beach, honey. You was at Cocoa Keys, Mount Laro. Your current situation. And you're going back this year, too. I've been to the Venetian. No, you was down in the Vegas. You caught that $200 special and you down there looking like you somewhere else. Because anywhere in Vegas, it look like somewhere else. Even they going to catfish too. They selling catfish by the tons. You want to look like you're in Italy, there's a place in Vegas you can go. You want to look like you're going to Africa, there's a place in Vegas you can go. You want to look like you went to Rome, there's a place in Vegas you can go. You spending your $200, you putting on your mask, you ninja you, and you going down there, sipping in the darkness. That's what you do. It's time to stop all that. You can really as long as you keep embracing the darkness, it's going to be the same thing that vitamin D to COVID. You are still susceptible for us to catch something really bad. But Father says today, bring the light. Around, I'm coming with the heat. See, you got a hat in your mind to bring the light.
Yes,
but when you bring the light, you ain't coming quiet. You're going to bring the noise with it. If you ever seen a thunderbolt, it brings the light and crack, it brings the noise. You bless the Lord. See, if you bless the Lord, when you start blessing the Lord, that ignition starts. It's like the pilot light on the gas stove. Bless the Lord.
Oh, Jesus.
Bless the Lord. Oh, my soul. My God. Because you're combustible. You bless the Lord, you turn into fuel. Makes you combustible. Makes you something that can be ignited with just one little click. So I walk around, I'm a flaming fire, and I walk around combustible. Soon as say, oh, bless the Lord, flick. Then come the boom. See. Bring the light. So you gotta bless the Lord. The Lord, then the lights start to fall on you. Then you start to be combustible for God. You're just one party waiting to happen. You're just one blessing waiting to happen. You're just one dream waiting to come forth. You're just one business about to leap out. You're one miracle that's just about to happen. You're one blessing after the next blessing that's just waiting to happen. All you need is just a little ignition. Bless the Lord. You sit there and say, I hurt my back. Oh, my pain. I owe the bill. Oh, I'm broke. I know so I need some gas. Oh, I'm empty. I need a relationship. Oh, give me a bone. School. So instead of bringing the light, you're bringing the dark. And you're bringing the noise of the complaint. You're bringing the noise of the depression. You're bringing the noise of the hardiness. Hardiness has a noise. Depression has a noise. Self-absorbing has a noise. Passive-aggressive has a noise. They all got noise. It's dark noise. Instead of a flaming fire, you're bringing freezing cold.
See, you got the light.
tonight. You look at that. Oh!
Yes.
Flaming fire.
Yes.
you. They thought they had you down, baby. They thought you was down for the last count. You went down one time, oh. You went down two times, oh. You went down, but on the third time, like they said, Jesus rose on the third day. You rise up and burn the flame.
You got to minister in the bathtub. You got to minister in the bathroom. You got to minister.
When you do your media, and you minister in your media, you minister in your writing, you minister in your putting together, you minister to the preachers, you minister to what you write, you minister to what you say, you minister to what you see, you minister to what you do. When you minister, and you minister, flaming fire.
Going bonkers,
and then the next thing that you start going to the pillars of hell.
Yep.
darkness is taking you straight there. Listen. Lucifer got caught by darkness because he started, he slept on it.
Wow.
He was so busy trying to achieve what God was doing that he was sleeping on darkness. He was too busy being upset because the humans was getting all these things that he slept on the fact he already had all these things. And he was too busy looking at God and what he was doing and looking at what decisions he was making because he was so he wanted to achieve and he was deceived.
Yes. Wow.
So when you're sitting around, you looking at what somebody else is doing, you trying to achieve. But you're not ministering, so you don't receive. So even if you achieve the title, even if you achieve the position, you still have no power. You are still a slave to darkness. In the position. Well, I'm talking to somebody. You in the position. Somebody said, I wanted to be a prophet. I want to be a prophetess. I want to do this. I want to serve. Yeah, that's all true. You wanted to achieve that. But did you minister? Have you ministered? Will you minister? Prophecy is a gift. It's a gift for ministry. And when you minister it to that, it will minister to you. Whatever it is that you achieve, you have to minister to it. So it'll minister back to you so you can receive. You sit there first, you start ministering, you start talking to each other. Yeah, see this one talking about. I can't stand it. The ministering, dark ministering. Yeah, you see that? And look, they don't see what's going on. Can't nobody see what they doing? See, look at that. Ministering. See, that's all I'm saying. But I'm doing all this. See, look, I'm doing all this. I'm just doing this. I ain't even all that, but I'm doing all this. You know, dark ministering. Then turn around there. They won't keep smiling all the time. I'm not the one that got problems. Why I got to stay every night? Ministering, dark ministering. All dark ministering. Oh my God, here they go, they're coming for me again. This one, are they always coming for me? Here I go. See, look at that. Dark minister. Yeah, and yeah, so what? I did make a whole lot of mistakes, but it don't matter. Everybody made mistakes, but look. Oh, I know she perfect over there. Look at her. Look at her. See, he perfect. Look at her. Yeah. Anybody, but they don't know she over there smoking over there doing this thing. Hell, but listen to me, yo, she's wonderful. She's great, but look what I ain't doing all that stuff. Look what's going on. Dark ministry. And the next thing you know, darkness overtaking you. And you just on a yo-yo of life, up and down. First you got, then you know. First you got, then you know. First you got, then you know. There you got, then you know. First you have, then you know. First you happy, then you sad. First you joy, now you miserable. Back and forth, back and forth. First you got energy, now energy. First you got energy, now energy. First you feel like it, now I don't. You just flip-flopping back and forth. Even your weight. First I'm losing weight, then I'm getting fat again. First I'm healthy, now I'm sick. You just back and forth. But here's the problem with your back and forth. All right. Here's the blessing that I'm looking to obtain. And it's right there. And that blessing is right there. And God is about to ignite me. To once he ignites me, it's going to give me enough power and force to overtake it. But the enemy knows this too. So then he get to tapping you on your shoulder.
Yep. That's true. My God.
Keep tapping.
Yeah.
What'd you say? She closer there than what I was. I was right there. What you talking about? Oh, Apostle Witness. Then moved her head, but I was right there. Yeah, well, you know, you used to be there. You ain't there no more. You know, you got a point. Then somebody comes to you and say, hey, listen, that's dumb. Oh, you're right, that's dumb. Why was I listening to that? All right, great, about ready to be ignited again. I'm ready, I'm combusting. I'm getting up to combustible. Here it come again. Look at the See, this is what I'm talking about. You need to stop minding your business. Stop messing with them and come over and do your thing. Okay, I'm coming. Here I come. I'm back. You're like, I was crazy. I shouldn't have been doing it. Here I go. Dang, they take it easy. I'm working hard over here. Shoot. I'm going to get that. I'm going to get that. I'm going to get both you couples back there. I'm going to be in that seat. I'm going to get that. I'm going to do me here. Let me tell you, you don't know what you don't. I know what to do. Y'all just don't know. You don't know. What? Leave them alone. Stop messing with them. Come on, mind your business. Okay.
It's a roller coaster. Mind your business.
But this time, you done went far, so far out now, it's further for you to get there. You can't go this far because now he got a leash on this, only allowing you to go this far.
Jeez.
Then we fight, trying to cut the cord, and break a little bit off you, and you get a little bit closer. Yeah. Then we fight, break a little bit, and then you get a little bit closer.
Come
then
on.
You get this far.
Go back again.
You ain't got to walk all that way. Go this way. Yeah, I'm here. What y'all doing over here? I'm going to be a part of this party. Oh, shoot. There's a lot of stuff over there. Oh, my God. That's a lot of stuff. See, you're a smart one. You always talking trash. Here you go. They don't want me there. They rejected me over there. Now I'm stuck. I can't go that way, and I can't go back that way. And darkness is over, overtaking me.
Jesus.
Now, the thing that was leading me to go back there was darkness. You didn't see him.
Right.
He was hidden in the light. He was hidden in the light. Because he was inside of you. Where it's dark, where you close your eyes. And so when you're sitting there and you're nodding, he keeps taking you back in there so he can talk to you some more in the broad daylight. Closer. His ministers is a flaming fire. It is time for you to get ignited. Whatever it is that you have to do, your ignition is in the ministry. Start ministering to you and everything around you. Even the air that you breathe, start ministering. Even the air that you breathe, minister. When you close your eyes at night, minister. My God, when you do your fingernails, minister. When you do your hair, do it, minister. Do it as prep. The light.